गुड मॉर्निंग सर, माय नेम इज़ अदिति सुनील राउत फ्रॉम फाइनल ईयर ग्रुप बायो एंड माय सेमिनार टॉपिक इज़ लॉ ऑफ एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ लाइट। व्हेन मोनोक्रोमेटिक या फिर हेटरोक्रोमेटिक लाइट इज़ इंसिडेंट अपॉन द होमोजीनियस मीडियम, सम पार्ट इज़ इंसिडेंट, सम पार्ट इज़ रिफ्लेक्टेड एंड सम पार्ट इज़ एब्जॉर्ब बाय द मीडियम एंड रिमेनिंग इज ट्रांसमिटेड। सो वी कैन राइट दैट आई इज़ द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ इंसिडेंट लाइट, आई ए इज़ द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ एब्जॉर्ब लाइट एंड आई टी इज़ द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ ट्रांसमिटेड लाइट, आई आर इज़ द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ रिफ्लेक्टेड लाइट। सो वी कैन राइट दैट आई इज़ इक्वल टू आई ए प्लस आई टी प्लस आई आर। इफ वी कंपेरिजन सेल इज यूज देन द वैल्यू ऑफ आई आर विल बी वेरी स्मॉल दैट इट कैन बी एलिमिनेटेड फॉर द एयर गैस इंटरफरेंस। सो द इक्वेशन विल बी आई इज इक्वल टू आई ए प्लस आई टी। लाइट एब्जॉर्ब बाय द मीडियम इज गवर्न बाय टू लॉज, फर्स्ट इज लैम्बर्ट लॉ एंड सेकेंड इज बियर्ड लॉ। फर्स्ट लैम्बर्ट लॉ, इट स्टेट्स दैट व्हेन अ बीम ऑफ मोनोक्रोमेटिक लाइट passes through the homogeneous absorbing medium, the rate of decrease of intensity of the radiant with the thickness of absorbing medium is proportional to the intensity of incident radiation. This law can be expressed as minus dI by dx is directly proportional to I. This minus sign indicates the change. So the equation will be minus dI upon dx. This proportionality sign changes into the equal to, and this is the constant k, I. This is equation 1, where I is the intensity of incident light, x is the thickness of medium, k is the constant which is known as absorption coefficient. On rearranging the equation 1, we get dI by I is equal to minus k dx. This is equation number 2. By integrating equation 2 and between the limits, this will become I is equal to I0 at x is equal to 0 and I is equal to I at x is equal to x. So this will be the equation by integrating, and by solving this we will get this, and finally we get the equation I is equal to I0 e minus kx. According to the equation 5, the intensity of the beam of a monochromatic radiation decreases exponentially with increase of the thickness, that is x, of absorbing substance, and this is the Lambert law. Now the equation 4 can be written as 2.303 log I upon I0 is equal to minus kx. This will be equation 6. Log I upon I0 is equal to minus k upon 2.303 into x. We rearrange this. Log I upon I0 is equal to, this is epsilon x. As we know that the value of epsilon is equal to minus k upon 2.303, which is called as extinction coefficient. And the reaction will be like this. Log I upon I0, I0 upon I is equal to minus, this will be the equation. Now we will see the Beer's law. It states that when a beam of monochromatic light passes through a solution of an absorbing substances, the rate of decrease of intensity of light with thickness of solution is directly proportional to the intensity of incident light as well as the concentration of the solution. This is like this equation, and by the solving we get the equation number 1. On rearranging equation 1, we get dI by I is equal to minus alpha into, this is C, that is concentration of the solution, and this is dx. Integrating equation 2 between the limits, we get that I is equal to I0 at x is equal to 0 and I is equal to I at x is equal to x. So by solving this we get the three equation, and finally we get the final equation, that is I is equal to I0 e minus alpha c into x. So according to this equation, the intensity of a beam of a monochromatic radiation decreases with exponentially with increase of thickness, that is x, and concentration c of the absorbing substance, and this is the mathematical expression of the Beer's law. Now by the equation 4 we can write that 2.303 log I by I0 is equal to minus alpha c into x, and by solving this we get equation, and we know that alpha by 2.303 is the epsilon, which is the molar absorbing coefficient. So we can write and we can put epsilon value in k in the place of alpha 2.303, and we get the final equation where the quantity log I0 upon I is the optical density or the absorbance of the medium, which is denoted by A. So we can write that log I0 upon I is equal to A, that is absorbance of the medium, which is equal to epsilon C into X. Or we can simply write that epsilon is equal to A upon CX. Now we will see the applications of Beer's and Lambert's law. It is used for the determination of bilirubin in the blood plasma sample. Also, it is used to determine the nature of poison. Now we will see the limitations of this Beer-Lambert law. It is limited by the chemical and instrumental factor. Thank you.